went to 5 weekend dance events, Eckville, Alberta, Billings, Montana, Rapid City and Mitchell in South Dakota, and Danceland east of Saskatoon. There were 4 weekdays between events, and since we drove, we were able to see things people flying missed. This is one of several videos that kind of go together. Maybe when I'm done, I'll put them all in a playlist so anybody that's interested can follow them. We are on our way to Mitchell, and like many travelers before us, stopped at Wall, South Dakota, for a 5-cent cup of coffee and a little shopping. You could buy a lot of things at the famous Wall Drug.
Unbeknownst to many, there are still 500 Minuteman missiles operational at this time across the northern Great Plains. In the central parts of North Dakota and Montana, the eastern areas of Wyoming, Colorado, and also western Nebraska. And those Minuteman missiles can hold triple the warhead capacity that the Minuteman II you are about to witness once did. Now, if I can get you to turn your attention to the interstate, I want you to imagine for nearly 3 decades, South Dakotans, tourists, and truckers, people just like yourselves, drove up and down that highway and hardly ever realized that they were driving through a war zone. Now, the missile is headed to a target half a world away, about 7,000 miles at most, and will arrive there in about 28 to 29 minutes. Well, this is the dead giveaway that you're seeing a silo. It's very hard to see this because it's flush with the surface. For nearly 3 decades of the Cold War, there was a plane that was always in the air known as the Looking Glass. It was actually a series of planes, but one was always up there flying 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, around the clock, almost 30 years. It was up there because if all the underground launch control centers were destroyed by a Soviet nuclear strike, the Looking Glass could assume control of every Minuteman missile in the United States, including the 150 here in South Dakota, and launch them. Do y'all have some questions?
On our way up here, we saw a fence like this, and I suspected what it was. So we drove up to it, and there was a sign that said, you're passing over a sensing device. We got out of our van, and we walked up to the gate, and in red at the bottom of other writing that said, keep out, it said, deadly force authorized.
Yeah. Yeah.
So was that an active site?
Where were you at?
Northern Montana.
Oh, yeah. I'm surprised they didn't. If you got back your car and drove off.
Well, we did drive off, and it's a good thing we did, because if the missile was launched, the 50-ton concrete cap would have blown off, and if we didn't get hit by that, a counter-missile strike would have vaporized us. Not even ashes would have been left. Our tour guide said that the missile sites are controlled in groups of 10. The manned stations are disguised as a farm, a ranch, or a house where people come and go. Anyway, we're thankful for our defense, and that the need to use these weapons hasn't yet come about. This deactivated missile site is beside the Badlands National Park. And since we had lots of time to get to Mitchell, and the music you are hearing in the background, we went for a hike on one of the many trails.
In the ashes of your letter, I am blue.
I was staring at Leola's boots, wondering how she could do all that mountain climbing without slipping or falling. When she noticed me looking at her, she showed off her legs.
How many of the gals out there can raise their hand and say that they told their guys that they love them? How many of the guys can raise their hand and say that they told their gals that they love them lately? If you haven't told them lately, now would be a good time.
Someone in, you reached up and turned my pictures low.